All right, so we're here in Dana Point, California, to try to figure out what it is that makes Dana Point a point. That's the point. Dana Point is a prominent headland that sticks out into the ocean about halfway between Los Angeles and San Diego. It made some killer waves for a while, and then they put in a harbor. It's also got some pretty great geology. Alright, so we're at the base of Dana Point Headlands, and you can see that the rock that makes it up is this red rock that's actually composed of many smaller rocks. And in sedimentary geology, any rock that's made up of many smaller clasts, or small rocks, that are greater than 2 millimeters across is either a conglomerate or a breccia. And what we're going to do is we're going to look at the shape of these inclusions to figure out which type of rock it is. So if we look up close, you can see that a lot of these clasts are very angular. So it's not like a rounded river cobble or something like that. Look at how they're very blocky, almost rectangular. That tells us that what we're dealing with here is a breccia. In this case, it's called the San Onofre Breccia.
It's a breccia.
Breccias tell us that there used to be hills or mountains nearby because the boulders didn't travel far enough from their source to be rounded down and made smaller. The San Onofre Breccia also contains several sandy deposits that contain shallow marine fossils, indicating we weren't too far from the ocean. So this used to be a coastal environment right next to hills or mountains. Most of the clasts within the San Onofre Breccia are a type of schist that occurs today on Catalina Island. Catalina is about 35 miles west of Dana Point with nothing but open ocean between. And San Onofre Breccia is also found from Malibu all the way to Tijuana, Mexico. I'm not trying to say that Catalina, Malibu, and Mexico were all right here, but it does suggest that they were once closer. During the Miocene, when the San Onofre Breccia formed, the large coastal arc of Southern California was once connected. But tectonic activity rotated the Malibu/Santa Barbara area out clockwise from San Diego. This rotation uplifted marine rocks like the Catalina Schist, and as it eroded, it created the boulders and cobbles we see in the San Onofre Breccia today. So, the San Onofre Breccia tells us a whole lot about the formation of the Southern California coastline. Alright, so we've moved into the harbor now, and we still have the San Onofre Breccia on our left, but there's a new rock on the right. This is the Capistrano Formation, and it formed around the start of the Pliocene maybe 5 million years ago. Now that's a problem because the San Onofre Breccia is much older. It's about 15 million years old, say, formed during the Miocene. And when we have two rocks that are of many different ages with millions of years in difference between them right next to each other, there's usually only one explanation, and that's a fault. And so to look to the fault, there's some obvious signs of it in terms of what's been done to try to support this cliff. But right behind me, you'll notice there's some engineering controls. There's blocks that have been done to try to shore it up. And at the top, you'll see there's a whole concrete face of the cliff. Right where that concrete is, that's where there's a fault that separates the San Onofre Breccia from the Capistrano Formation. And what that means is that the San Onofre Breccia has been kind of thrust up onto this rock here that's much younger than it. And it also means that you need to be careful dining at the top of this restaurant. It's on top of the fault. They've done a whole lot. I don't know. There's a whole lawsuit. You know, whose fault is the fault, man? It's a geology fund. Okay, so unlike with the San Onofre Breccia, which formed above the water or right barely in shallow water conditions, what we have at the Capistrano Formation is what's happening way underwater. And what you see behind me is the lower member of the Capistrano Formation, which is full of turbidites. And turbidites are basically underwater landslides. And so most of the time, underneath the ocean, it's pretty peaceful out there. Not a whole lot's going on. But occasionally, you have these moments where the slopes that are underwater will give, and it will make this sort of landslide that goes down. And that's what gives this kind of jumbled kind of look to the rocks behind me. So from this location, we can see some of the more recent geology happening in Southern California, which are marine terraces. So as you look out onto the point, you should see a series of kind of steps. And these reflect individual terraces that formed during periods of increased tectonic activity. During periods of stability, what will happen is waves will come and erode a cliff, and then totally flatten out everything beneath the cliff, making a beach. But when you have a period of increased uplift, what will happen is that beach will then get pushed up, and it will make one of these flat steps. You have that happen in a manner of series, and you get ancient sort of beaches and beach cliffs that form, representing these step-like formations.
The city of Dana Point is built into these ancient marine terraces. As we drive across the flat parts of Golden Lantern, we're traveling along a marine terrace that formed about 400,000 years ago. As we start to go uphill around the street Selva, we're going up where the sea cliffs used to be, that probably once looked a lot like the steep cliffs of the Dana Headlands today. At the top of the hill near Dana Hills High School, we reach an older marine terrace that formed between 500 and 800,000 years ago.
So here we are in the upper parts of the Capistrano Formation, and you can see that the rock here, unlike what we had in the lower members with the turbidites, is way looser, way unconsolidated mudstone. It's totally just fallen apart at the base of the hill. And so in this part, we have really weak rock all throughout this area, and it's caused a lot of landslides throughout South Orange County because this rock is really weak. So this weak mudstone represents formation at the bottom of the ocean. And unlike with the turbidites, which are really exciting, this sort of mudstone means this was just totally flat, totally calm, nothing going on about several thousand feet underneath the bottom of the ocean. So if you ever wonder what the bottom of the ocean looks like, it's this. It's just mud for like a long, long ways. Dana Point is made of San Onofre Breccia, which is a really strong rock as we saw before. Whereas where we're here now, we're surrounded by the Capistrano Formation, which is really weak. So the reason why Dana Point is a point is because it's made of the really strong rock that's surrounded by weaker rocks all around it. So that's why Dana Point's a point.